Here's the part number for the STI midpipe. I did get this for $226 shipped to my door. You can order it at any Subaru dealer, just gotta hunt around for the right deal. This thing looks really cherry. Looks better than I thought. Very nice. Look at the size of that resonator. It's big. There's your part number. STI midpipe. Really nice welds. Nice transitions. Let me get the papers off it. That's pretty much it. I'm hoping I don't need any gaskets. I mean, I'm sure I can use the ones that are on the car now, I pray, or else I won't be able to install it. Hopefully everything's all the same. Well, I gotta get some of that tape off it and stuff or it's gonna burn. It looks like a brand new piece, which it is. It looks better than I expected, actually. I thought it'd be kind of dented up and messed up because it's been sitting so long, but this thing is really cherry. I got the middle bolts out. Now I'm gonna do the rear on each side. It's a simple 14 millimeter nuts using a deep socket, and it'll require two hands and a longer ratchet. And there is a little gasket on here. See that thing? It's removable once I get this thing off. It's like a little fiber covered crush washer thing. Always give your hanger a spray. See it? There you go. Then slide it back and forth a little to get the lube dispersed, and now I can get it off. Definitely a two-hander to get this off. These pipes are very light. See, one-handed. They're light pipes. That, my friends, is what you call OEM fitment. Probably about an 18-inch resonator, more than a 12-inch actual body. It's really big. One more time, STI midpipe. I gotta see if I can carefully get these gaskets off, unless they get stuck. There we go. Nice little baby. Nice little baby. The first time you swap this, of course, it's easy. If I'm gonna do it 10 times, like I might, I'd buy a few of these new gaskets. But it is perfectly cherry right now. There's absolutely nothing wrong with it. So I got these bolts started. I'm not gonna torque them until last. I am gonna torque them properly. It's only 13 foot-pound. But I'm gonna first get the mufflers all lined up, then finalize this. You'll see what over-torquing it does. Since you don't have spring bolts, I can show you my old one too. You can see over-torquing a little bit. It just upset these a little bit, and the washers are never big enough for the whole entire hole. So I'll just bang this straight a little bit later, just for in case I ever need it. Also, I'll bend these tabs back straight. See, when you're over-torquing it, they're bending down a little bit, especially this ear here is bent down. So I'll take a really protected channel locks and just straighten it out. just for some point if I ever plan to reinstall it. So that's why you do want to torque your bolts. Those factory spring bolts, unfortunately, aren't long enough. And all the bolts are started. Now I'm going to make sure it's seated properly and start cinching all these up. About 5 minutes later, I have the bolts tightened. No issues whatsoever. They came off nice. They bolted together perfectly, sealed. Zero issues. This video literally started maybe 15 minutes ago. It's installed and complete. No clearance issues as you'd expect. Plenty of room. All up and down. Everything. Mongo resonator. And we have the same setup again as last time. Yard to the thing. The camera will be on top and the mic will be right about here. You saw that iPhone dB meter thing on the last video. That thing was just kind of useless, so I didn't even bother. I couldn't even see the screen on that thing. And there may be a little wind here, but I'll try and hopefully it turns out at least as good as the last one. I have not even heard this yet, guys. You're going to share the startup with me. Guys, that's killer. I can't even talk. So when you heard the idle rise back up, that's because it was a little cold, but I rev the exact same between 3 and 4,000 RPM as the last video, and it's far less raspy. I can't wait to go for a drive on this, really check it out. It looks like it made a big difference, so looks like this could be a killer mod for those that want something really OEM and nice fit. And a nice quiet stage too. It still has a little bit of tiny rasp, but if you put those two videos side by side and play them like back to back, I'm sure it'll be really easy to tell the difference. Hope you enjoyed this one.